And now to set the tone and context for this day, let me welcome in on stage an entrepreneur, a journalist, an internet evangelist, and a media expert, all rolled into one. Please put your hands together for Mr. Annurag Batra, Chairman, Editor-in-Chief for Exchange for Media and Businessworld. Please welcome in. You need a round of applause, please.
I'm a loud Punjabi. I normally don't need a mic, but I think it's a large hall. It's my honor and privilege to give a context to the Indian Marketing Awards. We first did the Indian Marketing Awards in 2004. I remember it because my daughter was born on 27th August 2004. And we did this on 6th October 2004. So I kind of remember, you know, we were preparing for it when the... I remember I went for a Radio Red, used to be our partner. And I went for an interview on that, talking about Indian Marketing Awards, and I know my daughter was going to be born in a couple of days. I didn't know it was a boy or a girl, but I know we would have a baby. So I remember we started Indian Marketing Awards 13 years back. Since then, the marketing landscape in India, the media and communication landscape in India has changed. For one, I had more hair when I started the Indian Marketing Awards. I can tell you that tonight the Indian Marketing Awards will be very big. Our jury chair, Mr. Anand Krupalu, who's the managing director of Diageo, will be here. He'll be our keynote speaker in the evening, and he will tell you how the jury process happened. And I can tell you that there's no more honest jury process than this. I can tell you a lot of my friends, and I have lots of friends in advertising, marketing, media, called me for various things. I had to politely decline and say I run Business World, I don't run Exchange for Media, which is a truth also. But the process is so honest, so robust that, you know, I don't think any awards process in our domain is that honest and that robust. What makes it robust is our jury. When you see the jury AV in the evening, you'll know that the jury is so heavyweight that they have a point of view on everything. They're themselves practitioners of the art of marketing, communication, and brand building. So they have a very deep dive view on everything, and they're very, very strong human beings. They have a point of view. Also, we did a huge pre-screening. We also brought in a marketing veteran to look at every entry and kind of make sure the entries were presented in a way that the jury could select from the entry. So when tonight you see the winners at the Indian Marketing Award, you'll know these are truly the Oscars of the marketing domain. Mr. Sumit Sani is here, and he's built a fantastic business for Renault in India, and he will talk about that. The leader who leads Airbnb is also here, and he will talk to you about how it takes a new approach to building a new kind of business. And we'll have my friend Shivjeet talking to leaders from the marketing, advertising, communication domain about how to build new age brands in this VUCA environment. Just to contextualize the Indian Marketing Awards, we created the India Brand Conclave to celebrate brands and businesses that live that philosophy that the Indian Marketing Awards celebrate. Let me ask you at this point, who's the world's greatest marketer? Who's India's greatest marketer? Who's India's greatest marketer? Narendra Modi? Yes, I would agree to that. So, you know, I normally don't use PowerPoint presentations because I believe PowerPoint presentations are used by people who are neither powerful nor have a point of view. I'm certainly not one of them. I've used this line before, it's not an original one. But, you know, Narendra Modi is more than a brand. He's more than a brand creator. Whether you like him, not like him, whether he wins an election, not, he's a unique phenomena. And he's not somebody who's just working on the brand. I think he's working on the product itself. Demonetization, GST is an example of what you need to do with the product. And whether you like, I like him, you know, for once he's a Virgo, I like Virgos. Me and my daughter are one. But that's not the reason. I believe the way Narendra Modi is projecting Brand India will bring dividends to our country. And just to give you, you know, sometimes when my Shankar, who makes tea for me, brings tea late, I tell him, Modi ji, itni der mein teen country ho ke aa jate hain, jitni der mein tu chai lata hai. So just to dramatize it, he's been to, you know, 49 countries in 3 years. And a lot of people say, so what? What has come out? The process of investment and building confidence and building focus on India is a long-term process. It's not that he would go for a visit and next day you'll have $2 billion lined up. It's a process. And I can tell you that, you know, when he addresses the Indian community, it does create a connect with India. It reinvigorates the connect with India. It makes sure that they look at India with a new light. And you know, again, I keep saying, do you know that after Modi came to power, most of the honeymooning couples stopped going out of India? You know why? Because he told them, make in India. No, but on a serious note, you know, manufacturing is the only way to make sure you create jobs, you create competitiveness. And a lot of economic experts believe that we've lost the bus on manufacturing. But what he's doing in defense and making sure that defense is such a large manufacturer, though it is mechanized business, you know, it uses robotics, but it still creates large number of jobs through his Make in India, through improving the ease of doing business. And again, I can tell you, India should be even more in the ease of doing business. The way the ease of doing business index is created, you know, it is not created for India, it is created for other countries. And we never focused on filling it well. So, you know, he's making sure that we actually portray what we have. And I promise you, next year and in the years coming after that, we will jump in ease of doing business. Because fundamentally, in lots of those parameters, we're very strong. He's also, you know, he's taking up visa issues with several countries, making sure we have visa on arrival. And when the Prime Minister of the country talks about the country and the brand that country represents, it does, in a world where your, you know, attention is being focused on China, it is being focused on Japan, it is being focused on a lot of other areas which are very lucrative, doing that works. Also, just during his, again, all marketers look at ROI. We did something, what happened? India has jumped 30 spots and made it to the top 100 in ease of doing business. I promise you, we'll be substantially higher. I don't know what that number would be. Moody's have upgraded India's rating from BA3 to BA2. And yesterday I was with Mr. YB Reddy, who's the former governor of RBI. And you know, ratings, we again should do better in future. We're fundamentally more solid than any banking system in the world. We are fundamentally the fastest growing market in any domain in the world. So really in rankings we'll do better because we've started to engage with that community. Also the Nikkei Asia Review, I can't not talk of media brands. Nikkei Asia Review forecast says the Indian economy will be number 3 in the world by 2028. That is 10 years from now. So really the foreign media, which does influence the decision makers that put money into India, does see India as the only bright spot in the world's economy. And again, I said, he's not just marketing. A lot of people say, oh, Modi's doing another event. He's talking about Startup India. But when the Prime Minister of the country gets onto the stage and he talks about being an entrepreneur, about failing, he's changing the mindset of the families, he's changing the culture of the society. And he's saying it's okay to fail. You know, that mindset change will manifest into successful ventures over a period of time. So really he's changing the product. He's not just marketing the product. The goods and services tax, I was with the Malaysian Prime Minister on 2nd April 2017. And in Malaysia, the GST is flat 6%. And he was telling me, I mean, he knows a little bit about politics and economy both. His father was the second Prime Minister of Malaysia. He was a Deputy Prime Minister of Malaysia for a long time before he became the Malaysian Prime Minister. And he was saying that, you know, GST is the right step in the right direction. Of course, he felt that our GST rates were high, though they will progressively come down. He also felt that the slabs should have been simpler. But the fact is that he believed somebody who understands economy and who's bringing GST helped that country endorse the fact that GST was being done for the right reasons in the right manner. And India, you got to do something. You cannot build a consensus, you know. Housing for all. Now, that may, you know, most of us here may have more than one house, but for a lot of Indians, having a roof over their house is very important. And again, the Americans and the Europeans talk about the inequalities in India, the stark poverty and the, you know, the wealth that a lot of Indians have. In some way, he's bridging that. He's changing the view of India. And it will take some time. It is Ujwala. It's written Ujala, but it's Ujwala. I did make this last minute, so I dictated the PPT, but it's Ujwala. Now again, a simple call to make sure that you give up subsidies. Wealthy people give up subsidies on the cooking oil, the gas that they get, created opportunities for a lot of Indians who need to get that subsidy. And I can go on. And again, demonetization, yes, in the short term, it has impacted our economy. You cannot deny that. But in the long term, and some economists would argue that in the long term, we are all dead. But in the near long term, I think you will see that this economy will benefit from this combined force of GST, demonetization, and the digital economy that is being created. And it's not, you know, again, it's not just about creating a scheme and creating the success, but it's how it's marketed. For example, after a week when LPG subsidy was formally announced, you know, I can play this video, but I'm sure most of you have seen it. And again, I wanted to sum it up. What is it about brand Modi that the marketeers can learn? Most of you are very good at your jobs. You build multi-billion dollar brands, you build businesses. But he's an innovator. He's a big risk taker. One thing, when Modi ji came to power, I went to a professor of mine who is a vice chancellor in Gujarat of a university, and I asked him, so what is that unique quality about Modi? He said two things to me. One, he said he's very big risk taker, and we saw that when he announced demonetization. So he's an innovator of a scale. Second, he's very dispassionate, he's very business-like. You know, he takes decisions without worrying about whether they'll impact, they could go wrong. But he's a guy who moves. So he's a, for innovation, you need to be both. You need to believe in something that is so different from what exists. Second, as I keep saying, he has the three C's. He has courage, communication, and he captures the mood of the moment. He understands across the world, if Trump has come to power, most of you would want to know why Trump has come to power. I've shared the secret why he's come to power in the past. For those of you who know, who don't know why Trump has come to power, would you like to know why he has come to power? Yeah, you know, he's come to power because my nutritional therapist, Rachna, tells me that when you eat junk food, your brain makes the wrong choices. And the Americans have been eating junk food for 60 years. But that's the non-serious answer. But the serious answer is that there is this belief across a lot of voters that there is too much of concentration of wealth in a certain section, and they've been left behind. So Modi knew that sentiment, and he captured on that. And he believes it's not always about the product and scheme. It is also about the perception your team creates around it, you create around it. You know, the narrative. My friends in the media keep saying Modi is a master of creating a narrative and changing the narrative when he wants. And why not? You know, if you're leading a country and you need to get everyone around you. And in this country, only two things matter. As my friend Arnab Goswami says in the TV business, what matters is ratings and what matters is advertisers. I'll tell you, in politics, two things matter. One is the fact is how many votes you get. And second is what you do with that mandate. I think, in my view, you know, we can keep talking about whether he's good or bad. He's moving on. You know, he's not trying to prove something right. He's trying to make it successful. I think that's the difference between Modi and everyone. And we cannot talk about marketing, communication, and advertising without talking about digital. He understands that most of the voters in India, most of the opinion makers are digital natives. Even those of us like Pankaj who are not digital natives, we are digital, you know, so to say, expats. You know, we've kind of went there. He's made sure he leverages digital very well. And most importantly, he appeals to people's emotions. You know, I travel a lot and I ask the, you know, taxi driver in Lucknow, what does he feel? I ask the taxi driver in Hyderabad. I ask the guard. You know, I talk to people who are not from the media, not from advertising, not from communication. And they say, you know, kuch to karenge saab. You know, that's the kind of, he comes across a man with a purpose. Again, I know that a lot of people love him and a lot of people don't like him. He's a very polarizing figure in some way. But the fact is, he come across as a person who has a purpose. You know, he appeals to the emotive side of people. So I think, you know, these are very simple and basic things that come across from Modi. But the fact is that sometimes we as practitioners and marketers forget. And as you know, I keep saying Philip Kotler, ask young people, do you know who's Philip Kotler, and tell them, by the way, he's not an IPL player. He doesn't play for Australia. But when I was in a business school, which is long, long back, we used to read Philip Kotler. And I would call Narendra Modi the marketing guru of a marketing guru. And just to substantiate that, when Philip Kotler, a couple of years when he came to power, was asked about Narendra Modi, he said, can't teach anything to Modi on marketing because he already knows everything. That's what Philip Kotler said. He's practicing, I mean, traditionally the four P's. Modi is really living the product, he's living the brand India, and he's also making sure that he communicates his idea of a new India. I also, you know, I have a role as, you know, I spend a dual role. Nawal spends all his time in E4M and runs E4M. I spend 99% of my time in Business World and 1% on E4M coming to the events. But I also want to use this opportunity to plug Business World. Since we acquired it 4 years and a month back, and we have a long way to go, another 6 months before we can be perfect in lots of areas. We have huge improvements to make. But I want to kind of tell you that Business World is no longer just a magazine. Sunil, who's our president, and Samir, who's our group CEO, is there. We are aiming for something bigger. One, of course, we are a magazine. In India, print still works, and read the latest issue of Business World. I think we in the print business do a very bad job of marketing ourselves. We have to play on the front foot because print has certain credibility and traction. I have a 13 and a half year old daughter. I got her a Kindle at 11, and she loves her Kindle. But, you know, she buys 20 physical books a month and reads them, not on her Kindle. She likes to read the newspaper. She shares a birthday with her dad, so she has some of those qualities. Point is, we are doing well in print. This is the last issue of Business World, which was our best B schools. And in magazines, you cannot be newsy, but you can be topical. We do 2-3 covers. We cook 2-3 cover stories. So the second cover was the economic cost of air pollution. What is the business cost of air pollution? Because it's topical. And we're an editorial product. I'm an editorial person, though I didn't go to a media school. I went to an engineering school and went to a business school. We continue to build and we'll strengthen print. You know, KPMG and PwC say the sunset years for print are 10 years. I've taken 5. I'm safe. I think print continues to grow with us. This is the last issue, current issue, which is on stand. We've done 3 covers. Our first cover is on the Lal Bhai Group, how it is becoming a non-textile group. He's moving away from textiles into value added, and it's moving from denims. They started at denims. Second is on Sanjeev Goenka and his forays, and what's working and what's not working with them. And third is the second coming of print. So we've done 3 covers in the order. And I don't want to talk about revenues, but you can see the number of ads. We have the highest yields. And I promise you, maybe not this year, next year in our IRS numbers and every number will be number one. We're already number one on stand sales. When we increased the price to 100 rupees 2 years back, everybody scoffed. Now everyone followed. We'll increase the price further. I don't want to lose money per copy. I believe if it's valuable, people will buy. And my subscription team was very worried about, you know, drop in sales and drop in subscription. Today they come and say, oh, it's the right decision. While we continue to build that, we built a digital business which is average 15 million traffic in a month. We want to be a 50 million site in the next 6 months, and the next 12 months, maybe 100 million. Samir comes from Yahoo. He led a 200 crore digital revenue business there. Hopefully, we'll build that in the next 3 to 5 years. We are building this clutch of businesses in digital, and we believe in the business of communities. I'm not in the business of magazine, websites, events. We do all that. But we're in the business of building communities. Of course, the main Business World brand is a B2C brand. And tomorrow it may be in 24/7 digital OTTV TV. You know, video is what will matter in the future. We may not do a traditional business channel, but we may do a new age. So we are using a legacy brand to create a new age business. And we have a long way to go. I mean, we have lots of things to improve. But I just wanted to take this opportunity to tell you we've built already 11 communities. We've showed 9 here, 2 on the way. We will launch Police World. So I just wanted to use this opportunity because I spend my business world time now. So I have to use the business world. So I just wanted to tell the, you know, every media brand sponsors the India Brand Conclave and the Indian Marketing Award. I didn't want to miss this opportunity to tell you what we are doing at Business World. I thank you for being here, and I hope we go back richer in knowledge. We make meaningful connections at the conference. And tonight when you see the jury members and the winners, you'll know that the brands and the people that have been awarded tonight have been awarded through a 3-tiered process of editorial, pre-screening, and a very rigorous, high-powered jury. I thank you for being part of our initiatives and wish you luck in the coming year 2018. Thank you. God bless you.